Today we're going to do a vase of flowers. This is just a small little art clip that you can use to decorate your home, put it on an invitation. I just think it's pretty. So we're going to get started with a pencil sketch. You want to get a canvas that's going to be a size you can handle. I recommend a medium canvas to start out with. Nothing too large or too small. This one's pretty medium. I'm going to just start out with a light sketch. What you want to do is look at your art reference. Put it close to your canvas so that you can keep an eye on both at the same time. I painted this little vase of flowers originally, so I'm not copying anybody else. You can use this art clip for anything. I think I've already mentioned that, but it's something that's very universal for just to keep. And what I'm doing is lightly sketching with a pencil exactly what I see, if I agree with it or not. Trying to keep it balanced, keep my hand steady. Put my pinky down on the canvas a lot of times just to hold my hand steady. Now I'm working on the base of the urn and the corners facing me. Just a light, light sketch. This is my eraser and it's your best friend. Don't be afraid of sketching because you can always erase it. Start again. I think the main thing and the hardest thing a lot of artists say is the drawing of your subject. That's usually the hardest part I hear from a lot of my students. But it's just something you need to practice and get comfortable with. Kind of learn your weaknesses and your style. Relax, get in your zone, and enjoy it. I'm just sort of eyeballing this to see if I've got it in the center of the canvas. I think it is. Now I'm just going to, with my pencil, place some things that I'll be adding paint to in just a minute. We're going to use acrylic today. Acrylic is kind of an easier medium to start with, but as you become a more developed artist, you'll see that it's not the easiest to do. Once you start using oil, you'll never go back. But acrylic is really a good medium to start with. It's a water-based medium, cleans up well, dries quickly, has a little plastic in it for protection, and the colors are usually very vibrant. Okay, now I've got the form basically of my urn drawn. Now I'm just going to kind of sketch where the flowers will go very lightly, because most of this I'll do with a paintbrush. But this will just help me keep my balance in perspective. Very, very light. Very, very light. Easy. Some of these little vines will go behind the vase, the illusion of them being behind. I want this little vase to be simple and elegant. Once I have my basic form drawn, what I need to do next to keep my lines in place, I use hairspray. You can also use an acrylic fixative that you can buy in art stores. I just lightly spray my canvas, air it out, and when we start painting, this will keep my lines in place. While that's drying, I'm going to go ahead and get my paint started. Now, got a paper towel handy to dab off my excess water, and we're gonna start painting. Go ahead and wet your brush. I prefer the nylon angled brushes. You have a point to use, they're sharp, they dry and clean up well. The key to a good painting is the correct brush. If you'll notice, I'm keeping my eye on my art reference. all the time. I think the best thing you can really learn the most from as far as painting is a still life. Setting up live objects in front of you and painting them from life. But today we'll just use a picture of a painting that I did earlier. You will learn a lot from still life painting, whether it be outside or inside. Now, with acrylic, it does dry quick. You do want to get a good base coat. You may have to do a couple of layers to get it on there thick enough. If you'll notice, this little flip area right here is supposed to represent probably a handle. We don't want it to look line for line perfect. I want this urn to look kind of old and crusty. I think it gives it the pretty artistic value that we want. There we go. I keep going back to my water, and that's what makes your paint loose and flowing. And all you use with acrylic is water. So it's a real good medium for beginners. If you'll notice, I am just pulling my paintbrush to represent the lines in this urn. I'm going to come back in a minute and do shadows. Let me start adding my green in to give it that mossy, crusty look. Now I've just got a bright green that I'm using right now. You can lighten your green up with yellow. You can darken it with your brown mediums. You can lighten it with white. Here we go. The base of this is starting to look kind of mossy. Bear with me. Let me get this on thick enough. Here's the other handle on this vase. It's not line for line, but if you're looking at it from a distance or anywhere, you can see what it is. Now I'm going to reduce down to a smaller brush in a minute after I get this base coat on. Here's your lines here. A steady hand is helpful to be a good artist. If you don't have a steady hand, the more you paint, the more calm and relaxed you'll become, and your hand will eventually adjust to your confidence. Okay, I'm going to a little bit smaller brush to get my lines a little more defined. Now, I'm going to use my black, and what I'm doing again is putting my pinky down on my canvas to hold my hand steady. And I'm just dabbing my brush in all these different colors to give it this old effect that I want on this vase. All the ones I put out are the ones I'll use. And if you'll notice on this vase, the highlight is coming this way, my light source. So my dark shades are going to be on this side. So on this side of the vase, I want to do a highlight area. Dip it in my ochre, my white. Pull it and make this side lighter all the way up the vase. And the thing about paint, you don't need to be afraid of it. It's just paint, and it can be painted over. I've had a lot of students, art people, they just gesso the whole thing and start again. So don't be afraid of it. This is a real, real good painting is therapeutic. You can get lost actually in your painting. It's a wonderful way to escape life and just have your creative outlet be right here on your canvas. Now I'm going to go over on the other side of the vase and use darker shading because my light's on the other end. So this side is going to be a little bit darker. Once again, nothing on this vase is perfect. We want it old and cruddy looking. I'm pulling my paintbrush down to create wedges that are in this face like this. Back and forth in your water. Your paper towel's right there beside you so you don't have a run or a drip. And it helps balance the wet content on your brush. Here we go. Now, I'm going to go up in here one more time with my dark. I'm going to try to create a line with these wedges all the way across, just by stroking like this. Sort of take your paintbrush if you want to create not such a straight line and turn it to the side and sort of smudge. It'll create a shadow effect over here too. Just sort of smudge it. Now the thing with acrylic, it dries fast, so you have to work fast on your smudging. Take your paintbrush, turn it to the side, and just kind of shove it around. Black is gonna go here pretty strong because we're gonna have some white dripping down over it, and you wanna show that this is underneath. Okay, strong under here because of a shadow. Now I'm smudging these shadows around now with acrylic. There we go. Now one thing I want to do on the vase too is I want to highlight just a little bit. So I'm going to dip it directly in my white, maybe a tiny little bit in the brown, and go over these edges right here. Pretty strong, this side. Real strong right here. Real strong down here. Remember, our light source is coming from this end. When you get finished with your painting and you like it, let it dry and you can erase all your pencil marks. And if you die a famous artist, your pencil marks makes your painting more valuable. All right, now one thing you want to do, it looks like it's floating in the air. Get your black and a real sharp edge on your paintbrush, and you want to darken the bottom of this face so that it is grounded. Like I said, your light source is here, so I'm creating a shadow on this side. Pull it on out like this. I actually got that a little dark. Let me get some white back on here. I wish all I did was canvas work. It is so much fun and it's so relaxing. And you can just lose yourself. You really can. There we go. Now, before, I'm not quite finished with the urn, but I do want to go ahead and get started on the flowers. What we'll do is, if you'll notice back here is a dark area. You always start from your background forward. So we're going to get the dark on the background of this flower here, or this vase, and we're going to smudge in some background work, just some dark background. Then everything else will be on top of that. Let me show you. Just get a little black, a little burnt umber, wet your brush again, and start smudging around this back. Just smudge this dark on top. No, that doesn't look like flowers yet, but you'll see the depth a whole lot better by making your background dark. I'm just smudging in this dark, and I'm going to bring it on up just a little bit. There we go. Now, we're going to start with our green. And I'm going to actually take it and just pull it out like this, very lightly. Holding my pinky down on the canvas, take your brush down and pull it. Same way with this, take it up and pull it. Let's create some of these really light ones. I'm gonna dip it in white and really pull some of that lime out. You can adjust the colors to whatever palette fits where you want this piece to be. Go, adding some more white to it. Now this all these plants. There's all kinds of little teeny delicate flowers. I don't know what kind they are. It looks like maybe some baby's breath. I'm gonna get some okra and brown and put some little other pieces in here. Maybe some dried flowery looking things in here. And we want it to pull. We want it to be centered on the canvas, so you gotta make it as tall enough to make it balance. Okay. Let's do some leaves. I'm gonna deepen my green a little bit again by adding brown, dipping it in two or three different things. And I'm gonna start up here and very lightly just start doing some leaves. This brush is perfect for just some little tiny green ferny-like leaves up through here, and they're gonna be scattered. I want this to be light and airy. I'm just kind of dabbing these little things all over the place. I just take my paintbrush and throw it in all kinds of green and yellow. There's not even a stem to this one, but we're just going to take these up. Some way up here. Let me get some white on this. There we go. It's light and airy. I'm just taking it very lightly on the canvas and then just kind of pulling away. Now, I'm gonna add some loose leaves down here too. Don't really know where they came from, but they're there. Lime green is a big color this year. Now these vines go behind the vase, and I'm just going to very lightly pull them around. Added some brown just so you can see it. There we go. Once again, very, very lightly, I'm starting to pull some vines, just pull them very, very lightly. And acrylic is a bright colored paint, so you have to mute it down with your whites and your browns. Now, I want to add some flowers. So I'm gonna get red. Got my white on my palette already. Just gonna do a little drop of red. Red goes a long way. Clean my brush, dip it in my red, mix it with the white, and add some real pretty white, pinky, white and red together. And then just dab some flowers in here. I'm not sure what kind they are, but doesn't matter. The dark and the white together, light together, make it create depth. Here we go, all over in here. Now I don't want to see any start-stop points. So where you see that dark stopping, get up there with your flowers or your green so that it goes away. Now, I'm gonna clean my brush again, get into just pure white. I may have to throw some more out there. Okay, and I just want some white on these. These are probably baby's breath, and this is a good color to get rid of that start-stop line right there. This little vase of flowers would be pretty on an invitation, be pretty, maybe on a thank you note. Now before I get too much further, I am gonna get some more white out. This is a more, in the tube has more, a stronger pigment. And I want to get my medium brush again, not the smallest one, but this medium sized brush with an angle. Dip it in my white, and I wanna create this pulled down effect on this urn. So I'm going to take my brush and I'm going to take it and pull it. It's like this. Over and down. And I'm not really sure what this is hanging off this urn, but it looks kind of cool. Take it right on the rim and pull. Don't make it even. It wouldn't be even in real life. Okay, now I'm gonna add a little bit of black just to give it some variance. And some depth. And some age. I'm gonna get it into a little brown to make this just a little different than the original here. It just needs that. And I'm gonna age this up just a hair. There we go. Looks a little older. Now, let's go back to our flowers. I'm gonna add a little more color up here, get rid of my start stop. And then I'm gonna go back to the green. We're almost finished. The only thing I want to do while my brush is wet and this color's on here, I'm going to come down here and do this little glob of flowers that's have fallen off, and they're sitting at the base of the urn, right here. Here's your baby's breath. Now let's get into our green again. And do these delicate little leaves. And we want to keep it flat so that it looks like it's laying on the ground. Okay, so where your shadow is, it should come on out from that. There we go. Let's add a little more depth by some black, showing that it is on the ground, and shadow these things. All right. I am going to also get my black and do some darkening up in here while it's on my brush. Darken some of these areas. Just give it some depth. And I'm just getting my paintbrush and I'm just scooting that black here and there. And it adds a little depth to it. Now I'm going back to my greens. We're just about finished. A little brown on that green. I'm going to add some more leaves. Some more dried, sticky looking things. Kind of, you don't know what they are, but they should be there. Taking the tip of my paintbrush, making some little dots. It helps make it look a little more real. Now, let's get a solid green again and make one of these branches come down in front. Some more leaves right here in front where they're just falling over. This is the fun part. You can just stay loose with it. This is where you get creative and you just put it where you want it to go. And a hand-painted piece is going, everyone's going to look different. They shouldn't all look exactly the same. Just kind of going crazy with my green here. Filling it up, hiding my start-stop lines. Going back down here at the bottom, filling that in. Now, I'm gonna work just a little more on the urn and we'll be finished. Hang on. Let's go a little bit deeper with that green again. It just needs some depth. I'm just gonna have some leaves just here and there. You should, after you've been painting a while, have your own style that you'll start noticing. And most of the time, no matter what you paint, you'll be able to tell that it's yours. Okay. I'm gonna go back one more time, do some more depth on my urn, just a little bit right here, a little bit under here. Pull this up, add some more crud. Since that acrylic is a little drier now, I'm gonna add a few more lines down here. I use my fingers a lot. I use paper towels, I use saran wrap, I use whatever it takes to get the look you want. Okay. All right, there's your vase of flowers. This should dry within 10, 15 minutes. This piece can be used, like I said, just for decorative appeal. You can go have it copied. Use it for an invitation, thank you notes. A little piece like this is really good to learn how to do. It's a good practice piece. Thank you for joining me today, and stay creative.